So let's begin this particular course on Terraform with first I giving you an overall picture of what you are going to get as a part of this training. So we are going to begin with introduction to Terraform. What exactly is Terraform, the importance of Terraform, how Terraform can be used for provisioning infrastructure in almost all cloud service providers today. It can be Azure, it can be AWS, it can be GCP, and not necessary cloud alone. So many other alternatives are also available. How Terraform can be used to provision a Docker container. What exactly is the architecture of Terraform? How does it internally work? This part we are going to see in the introduction. And then would come the main topic, starting to provision resources. It can be Azure virtual machine we want to create through Terraform, or it can be AWS EC2 instance we would like to create through Terraform. And when we are working with resources, we go deep dive into understanding how the meta arguments can be used, which can be count for each, and few more meta arguments we are going to cover over here. As a practice session, I would give you entire script for provisioning a load balancer. And of course, if you want to do VNet peering in Azure, we would like to see how existing resources which are already there in the cloud, it can be Azure, AWS, suppose a virtual machine is already there, and if you want to start managing that virtual machine in the Terraform, if you want to read data from that virtual machine, if you have a storage account, if you want to use that storage account while working with other resources in the Terraform, how to use data sources we are going to see there. Terraform lets us to connect to multiple sources with the help of providers. So in this particular chapter, we'll go deep dive into what is Terraform provider, how we can use multiple providers in the same Terraform configuration file, how can be version constraints respected when we are writing a Terraform, how the conflicts have to be resolved, what is plugin DIR argument. Similarly, we are going to see state and state backend. What is the importance of state? Most important topic I could say in Terraform actually, because once the resources are provisioned, we would want to change the properties in the Terraform configuration, and the change of the properties in Terraform configuration, we should be able to apply. We should be able to do something like incremental updates, or we should be able to selectively delete the resources which are not mentioned in the Terraform script. How we can fetch the state of an already existing resource into a Terraform application. Those things we are going to see. Basically handling drift, change of state from the Terraform script and the change in cloud. If somebody directly edits the cloud, how to handle the drift we are going to see over here. Then we will do deep dive into HCL language, understand various aspects of the language, what are variables, how input variables can be used, output variables can be used, local variables can be used, how different provisioners. Basically, if you have a virtual machine, in a virtual machine, we would like to execute some script. How from Terraform we can execute those scripts. For example, I would like to install a web server in a virtual machine. It can be Apache web server, it can be Nginx web server, or if it is Windows based IIS web server, how we can install that. And we don't want to log in into the virtual machine. Without logging in into the virtual machine through RDP or through SSH directly, through Terraform we would like to achieve something similar. Or what is the alternative of provisioning provided by Azure or AWS? Those things we are going to see there. Another important topic, reusability, working with Terraform modules, writing modules so that we can call those modules, basically the child modules, from the parent modules, which can be modules present in the directory, subdirectory, modules which can be uploaded to GitHub and then reused, or modules which can be uploaded to S3 bucket of AWS and then reused. How different modules can use different providers, and how same provider, but we would like to use different connections. For example, in Azure, I would like to have some resources created in one subscription, some resources created in another subscription. Likewise, in AWS, we would like to provision resources in different regions. How we can do that? What are the different ways we can handle workspaces? The concept where we would like to have dev environment state separated from queue environment and queue environment state separated from production. And also we would like to have probably different in their names. So through workspaces, we manage that. Terraform, how to do debugging, how to do logging, working with collections in Terraform, HCL language only. We are going to go deep dive into collections, working with list, tuples, maps, objects. In case we want to do type conversion, what are complex types? These things we are going to cover in working with collections. Built-in functions are there in Terraform. How to use those built-in functions to make our life easy in a configuration file. Basically, say for example, we want to work with mathematical functions, string functions, or Boolean functions. Likewise, we have functions which can work with reading of a template file and performing operations on the templates. How to use Terraform in a CI/CD pipeline. How we can use Terraform for provisioning an AKS cluster or an EKS cluster in AWS. And then also I'm going to provide to you a hackathon project which you are supposed to do and share the solution. Of course, I would also share my solution, but ideally you are supposed to complete that and share the solution with me, against which I will share my solution with you. So this is the entire Terraform training. I mean, quite deep dive, not at the surface. Almost every topic we are going to deal with be pretty deep into the concepts. Every topic I'm going to show you the demonstration practically. Nothing will be simply conceptually shown to you. So this is how the overall Terraform training is going to happen. Basically, this is the roadmap for the entire training for us.